less than a second, right. It feels like. You know, with Sheik getting a combo, it'll last forever, but it'll take a while. With Luigi, he gets down throw, down air, re-grabbed, like, forward air, back air, up air, and it's just, like, 70%. It's like, it all happened in, like, a second and a half.
Right, and however, the upside for the heavies here is that both of these characters, Rob and Bowser, or Rob and Luigi, struggle to land big time. And what the heavies are very well known for, besides their grappling abilities, is their ability to trap your landings and just to keep you in the air and juggle you for a long amount of time.
And then once you run out of fuel?
Yeah, and then a dropkick came out and almost killed Luigi. It might very well right here with an edge guard, but no. Mankey opting to not. However, a ding-dong coming out with great awareness, knowing that Rob was going to be there trying to get him out of there.
When that's that up tilt up air, that is a true combo. Can be really hard to land in singles because of up tilt's awful hitbox. But there we see it. It's probably going to be more of a factor in the double setting. Oh,
like, great wave right there by Mankey, and then it's going to get a quick get up attack punish.
Really smart there, and you have to.
Oh, and an SD coming out from Professor MGW, down airing a whole lot of lag after that, and that's very costly for them.
Oh, getting that re-grab too, but it will end up costing him the stock as Bang is able to get the counter. The up air not going to kill though, not enough rage on Rob yet.
And so many early stocks coming out on Professor MGW, really losing both of those stocks. And he's going to lose another one right here to the ding-dong. No, a little bit too much rage, but another up air almost taking the stock once more from Professor MGW. Oh, and a great roll read by Marshall to take that stock with an up smash. And they're going to be forced into a share stock situation. And the red team still with a whole five stocks. Mankey holding down these stocks incredibly well.
Yeah, and right now they can just play liberally.
Right.
Red team. You know, they don't have to worry so much about the risk of hitting their own teammate. They don't necessarily have to worry about the risk of losing stocks.
Speaking of the devil, obviously a little bit of team kill right there, but Mankey was at such a high percent that in the end it doesn't really matter all that much. Almost another back air conversion there.
He got that air dodge read with the up smash.
And that's the thing, once Rob loses his jump, he doesn't have a whole lot of mobility or places to move.
Well, he is able to stall a little bit with his uppie, even when he, because, you know, he, like, stalls him in place a little bit, which can make his landing a little bit more tricky. But for the most part, yeah, he can really struggle to land.
Right.
Oh, and again, covering those ledge options, but a really smart forward smash from Bang. But at this point, it's looking pretty risky, and we got that up air, but once again, Rob's down throw it takes a long time.
Oh, and what a conversion by the red team. Grab from DK just into a straight down air from Bowser. Huge knockback on that move. Going to be able to take Luigi's stock.
All right, and Rob does have some amazing keep away game, but
not enough keep away game to keep away from that invincible Bowser up smash.
And the up air.
In the, or up air, my apologies. And actually, in the background right there, as that match was going on, big pop-off coming out from Otacon. And 809, so they took it over SBT and Bao, losing actually pretty early in this bracket.
Yeah, but that means that Otacon and Otacon and 809 are going for that loser's run. They got knocked into losers round one pretty much.
Right, yeah.
And right now they've already made it into top eight, where they will be playing against
Paul D and Simon. So I think we are missing the switch from Professor MGW. A whole lot of early stocks lost by him. A whole lot of SDs as well. Very unfortunate. First time he just lost fuel. Second time was an SD. And then third time it was just an edge guard. And there's not a whole lot he could do about it. And the thing is with Rob, he is, on the easier side to edge guard, being that fuel is so reactable and slow. So,
well, the thing about Rob when he's recovering is you have to respect his up air and his hitboxes, because he can act freely out of his upbeat. But beyond that, you know, he can't stay off stage forever because of the limited fuel.
Right.
But it looks like we won't even have to worry about that, because we see the character switch to Greninja. Very interesting, and I do like Greninja as a pick. We saw how the landing traps were a huge issue for him in that last game, as well as those unfortunate SDs. So this time he's looking to just go with the Greninja, and up tilt, that is a disjoint, which means it beats out that Bowser down B.
Right, and the thing is with Greninja, he can always, in that last ditch effort, opt to either Shadow Sneak or to Hydro Pump out of that situation.
I can't believe he did that. That was so cool. Oh, he tries to get the punish on that Nair. Really smart there, using the double up B. This is a thing about Luigi when he's recovering. If you get hit by his up B, you can often punish with, like, I believe it's frame 3 option, and you can just immediately do it.
And the issue with Bowser's Koopa, as opposed to Ding Dong, Ding Dong actually does move move Donkey Kong's hurtbox a significant amount, obviously, because he's jumping. Bowser leaves a huge hurtbox there to hit, which makes it very difficult for him to get up to the confirms because it's super duper reactable.
Oh yeah, but also the thing is you have to respect the throw animation.
Right.
Because we haven't seen it yet, but it has the jankest hitbox.
Oh right,
in
and
existence.
It sends at such a, horizontal angle.
On half the cast it's an insta-kill.
Yeah.
On half the cast it's an insta-kill because it just sends them at what a spot dodge read.
And he's gonna even this game right back up after a pretty early stock from Professor MJW on Marshall, and wow, Marshall just going into work on Bang.
Ooh, and we see Bang going for these jab-jab mix-ups, but I know that Marshall has a Luigi himself, and so he is just knows how to deal with them. Can he go back down and
oh
save
no,
his,
why?
And the double? Yeah, he really wanted to save his teammate there, and I've seen that happen. I have fallen victim to that myself. You're so desperate to go for that team-saving play that you end up losing your stock as well. And so, just like that, the stock count is evened up despite all of that comeback work that Red Team had put in.
Right, and you have to wonder as to why really he did that, because Donkey Kong was already basically at death percent, and really he was at such a low percent that
he was above.
Above 100, but still, as Bowser, you're living for a long time, so it's really not worth saving your teammate when he's already at like 170.
I mean, once again, as DK has that survivability too.
No, right, but.
There it is!
Yes!
We talked about it. That was the crazy hitbox, and it ends up coming out really in Red Team's favor.
And really forcing the share stock situation. Obviously, Marshall's going to have to hold down stocks pretty well here. The landing flare breath, very solid. Going to allow him to get back F-Smash option at 4%. Not sure I agree with that, but the super armor coming out from the cargo throw. He's going to be able to get out of that situation.
That is another reason why Ding Dong is kind of just preferable to Koopa in the double setting. It does have super armor when he is grabbing his... No, it's actually not super. It's heavy armor.
Yes.
It's heavy armor. So a strong enough knockback move will break it.
Oh, and that soft back air still not going to take it actually just yet. Surprising me, but Hydro Pump still not going to be able to make it back to the stage.
And right now...
Luigi at 1% has a shot here. Because Luigi can, again, end the stock early, and that's going to be one way to do it. And Share's not going to come out? Yes, yep. I think it is the better match for the two, actually. So I'm happy that they ended up making this move here. Back air, no air dodge coming out. Very smart from Bang.
And also really smart from Mankey. He is not really going in, which is, on the one hand, kind of defeats the purpose of the 2v1. On the other hand, it's keeping him alive. He is at such high percent that there
yes,
is
beautiful
really
conversion. I think almost making up for that shield bait punish earlier by Marshall and Mankey. A nice little Bowser's up throw to the DK punch. Very precise in that in that combo.
And that was so smart. I was at first questioning why Mankey was hanging back so much because they lost that sort of, you know, the presence of the 2v1. But then we saw that he was able to, as soon as Bowser got the grab, he got that. He had that fully charged Donkey Punch, meaning that he was able to kill much even earlier than they normally would.
Yeah.